H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Welcome to another video of H2K Infosys. In this particular video, we will see another part of abstraction, and we will see how do we create abstract methods and what are the things that we need to understand when we create abstract method. So let us look at the theoretical points of abstract method, then we will go to the practicalities of it. First of all, if you want a class to contain a particular method, but we want the actual implementation to be of that method to be determined by a child class, we declare the method in the parent class of abstract. Now, what do we mean by this? When we declare a abstract method in a parent class, it means that we want to implement that abstract method in the child class, which is inheriting the parent class. So that is what it is given out here. If you want a class to contain a particular method, so class can contain a particular method, but we want the actual implementation of that method to happen in the child class or to be determined by the child class, we can then therefore declare the method in the parent class as abstract. Abstract is the keyword to be used with methods that are declared as abstract. Okay. And you need to place the abstract keyword before the method name in the method declaration. An abstract method contains a method signature but no method body. So generally, we have seen until now concrete methods. Concrete methods do have the body part which is within the curly braces. So abstract method will have the name of the method and the keyword called abstract, but it will be not having the body part, that is, it will terminate with a colon sign. So that is what is given in the next point. Instead of curly braces, an abstract method will have the semicolon at the end. Okay. Other things which are important for abstract method is that when we declare abstract method, ensure that the abstract method is declared within an abstract class. We cannot declare an abstract method in a public class or a class which is not abstract. Secondly, abstract method has to be non-static. You cannot have a static abstract method. And the reason for that is that an abstract method will have to be implemented in the class which is inheriting the abstract class. Okay, and this third part is that abstract class can have concrete methods as well as abstract methods. Okay, and the fourth part is that abstract methods declared in an abstract class can be only public, protected and default. Abstract method cannot be private. Now we have seen what is public access specifier, we have seen what is default access specifier, we have seen what is private access specifier. The main is it protected. So we will see that. Before going to those examples of defining the access specifiers for abstract method, why do we need to understand why do we declare a method as abstract and what is the consequence of it. The declaration of a method as abstract is for the simple reason that the implementation of that method will happen in the child class, which is inheriting the parent abstract class. And what are the consequences of declaring a method as abstract? The class containing the abstract method must be declared as abstract. That means you cannot have a simple class where you can declare an abstract method. The abstract method needs an abstract class. Now the vice versa is not true. An abstract class may or may not have abstract method. Second consequence of using an abstract method, any class inheriting the current class must either override the abstract method. So any class which is inheriting the abstract class must either override the abstract method or declare itself as abstract. Otherwise, you cannot use the abstract methods and implement it in the class that you are trying to get inherited. So let us see certain examples of abstract methods. For that, I have my Eclipse already open. And I'll create a new project called as Session 28. Click on Finish and say No. In this particular source folder, I'm going to create a new package by right-clicking on the source folder and choosing the option of New and Package. The package will be called as, let's say, Abstract Method, to depict that it is nothing but a discussion on abstract method. And inside this package, I'll create a class file called let me create an employee class, employees class, and I will not call it as abstract at this point of time. And I will not call the main method. So let us understand the concept of abstract method out here. Now, if we declare an abstract method inside this employees class, okay, it has to be non-static, first of all, and it can be only public or protected or default access specifier based abstract method. Now, why public, protected and default? Because they can be visible in the package across all packages, or in the package or across packages which have classes called subclasses. Okay, so we can have abstract method which should be non-static. We cannot create static abstract method. First of all, and abstract method needs to use the keyword, uses the keyword called abstract. And the access specifiers that the access specifiers that can be used, we use for abstract method are public. We know what is public. Public means something which can be used across all packages in a project, and it can be used in default. An abstract method can be default, default based across all classes present in a particular package, and across an abstract method. And you can also use the access specifier called protected for abstract method. And what is protected? I'm going to define it. I'll put this under block comment. So we have seen in the last session what do you mean by public, default and private. Okay, now what is protected? Protected is also an access specifier, and protected can be used. In classes of a classes of the package the package means a particular package might have a lot of classes. See, one of the classes is defining a protected access specifier. It can be used in the classes present in that package and in other packages, but with the inheritance effect. That means the other packages will have classes which are subclasses of the classes present in the package in which the protected access specifier is used. So protected is nothing but an access specifier which can be used in the classes of a particular package and in other packages also, but in with the inheritance effect. Inheritance effect means other packages should have classes which are subclasses of the classes present in the package in which the protected access specifier is used. So that means other packages will have classes which are subclasses and the parent classes will be present in the package where the protected access specifier is used. So we can have abstract method using this particular access specifier. I'm going to do a block comment. And the next thing that I'm basically defining is private access specifier cannot be used for abstract method. The compiler will show a problem. Now why? Because if you look at default, it can be used across classes of a particular package. That means the visibility of that access method, abstract method, will be there for it to be implemented in other classes. Similarly, abstract methods can have public access specifier because then it can be actually implemented in the class which is inheriting the class where the public abstract method is declared, and it can be actually implemented in all packages present across the project. So the visibility is across the world, you can say. And protected means that it can be used in the package in which it is created and in the other packages whose classes are inheriting the parent class present in the package in which the protected access specifier is used. That means the visibility of protected is also there in the classes of a particular package plus in the classes of the other package if those classes are inheriting the parent class present in the package in which the protected access specifier is created. That means visibility is there. So that is why if the visibility is there, I can implement the method in other classes for an abstract method. And that is why abstract method cannot be private. If I make an abstract method private, what is going to happen? It can be only used in the class in which it is declared. An abstract method cannot be implemented in the class in which it is declared. It has to be implemented in the parent, in the child class, which is inheriting the abstract class. That is why private access specifier cannot be used for abstract methods. Okay. Plus, you can also, apart from abstract methods, an abstract class can have concrete methods, that means methods with the body part, concrete methods, and these concrete method can be static or non-static and use any access specifier. like public protected default and what is the last one? Private. Put a comma. So I put a block comment. Last point is that if an abstract method is present, the class has to be abstract. One thing I have not declared for protected is that it can be used for methods, global variables, that's all. The class has to be abstract, and last point is that abstract and final keyword cannot be used together. A class can be abstract, a class can be final. So you cannot use these two keywords together. A method can be abstract, a method can be final. You cannot use these two words together in a method. Global variable cannot be abstract. It can be but final. So let us remember that. And now I can create a simple technique to show you an example of this abstract method. So I can create an abstract method out here.